This experimental simulation explains the working principle of a capacitor. A capacitor is formed of two conducting surfaces facing each other and separated by an insulating material. In this simulation, the insulating material is air. Initially, and on each plate, the number of the electrons is equal to the number of the protons, so each plate is neutral, and we say that the capacitor is uncharged or neutral. Observe what will happen when we connect the upper plate of the capacitor to the positive pole of the battery and the lower plate of the capacitor to the negative pole of the battery using this switch. We observe that the upper plate of the capacitor loses a certain number of electrons, while the lower plate of the capacitor gains the same number of electrons because the positive pole of the battery attracts some of the free electrons on the upper plate of the capacitor to this plate, becomes positively charged, and since the lower plate of the capacitor gains a certain number of electrons, so it becomes negatively charged. This phenomenon is called the charging of the capacitor. Electric equilibrium is attained when there is no transfer of electrons between the battery and the capacitor. Now, since we have charges or accumulation of charges on the two plates of the capacitor, so we have a potential difference between these two plates, or a potential difference is created between these two plates. Let's measure this potential difference using the voltmeter. We observe that the voltmeter measures a voltage of 1.5 volt equal to that of the battery. Now observe what will happen when we disconnect the battery using this switch. We observe that the potential difference between the two plates remains 1.5 volt and the charge on each plate doesn't change because we have an insulating material between the two plates, so electrons cannot transfer through this insulating material. Now, the charge capacitor stores electric energy and acts as a small battery. Now, observe what will happen when we connect this charge capacitor to this lamp using this switch. We observe that the lamp glows for a certain time interval and then it dies out. And also we observe that the volt between, or the potential difference between the two plates decreases to zero and the charge finally becomes zero because the excess of electrons on the lower plate of the capacitor transfer through the lamp to the upper plate of the capacitor. So finally the charge on each plate becomes zero and the voltage becomes zero, so the lamp dies out. This phenomenon is called discharging of the capacitor.